हेलो हेलो, एम आई ऑडिबल? हेलो हेलो, ओके शांत। हेलो
हेलो,
हेलो, एम आई ऑडिबल? समबडी कैन टेल इफ अशांक, यू कैन म्यूट योर सेल्फ।
हेलो
फाइन आदर्श, राइट।
वन सेकेंड।
Sounds English culture, right? Others, you are from which school, dear?
हेलो हेलो,
Can't hear it. Okay, your voice is very low. Can anyone confirm that is it actually low? Then I'll just see.
I'm even in my earphone, your voice is low.
In yours also it's coming low? Right, I'll just
Yes,
see.
ma'am.
Wait. Now is it okay? Anyone can reply back, not a problem.
Is it okay from my side?
Yes, ma'am, it's okay now.
It's okay, fine. So we are just starting in next 2 minutes, so, right?
Okay, ma'am.
So what all you have done? Have you all done anything linear equation, one variable now? Have you all practiced? You can write in the chat.
Yes, ma'am, I have practiced.
Any problem coming to your way, you can write in the chat box so that I can keep it in mind while teaching. No problem. What was the problem? Tell me that. Adarsh, any problem in linear equation if you have practiced? Any sum which you are not able to do in age? Okay. Can you write the problem? What is your problem there? Or you want, you can unmute yourself and tell. What is your problem? Your wish, whatever way suits your requirement of writing. Others, you can write your problem in ages. What is your problem? Or okay, let me have few questions because I have taken few questions for you all in this house.
Mama, I have no problem.
Okay, you are not having any problem. Okay. So fine, let me start, right? Today is your fifth session of linear equations. Yeah, it's a big chapter, but definitely it requires a little bit of your attention. Then only you will be able to manage good marks. The linear equation is a very, very scoring chapter. And if you want
yes, to, ma'am, we can start.
Practice a little bit so that you are not leaving any stone unturned, right? So you should practice a lot and then just go on to the basic introduction and basic hints what we have given you. You will be able to manage your questions, right? So coming ahead of it. Yeah. Just before starting, few instructions. Keep yourself on mute and anything you want to speak it out, you can write in the chat box. I'm definitely looking into the chat box also. Please keep your notebooks handy so that we can all practice it from there, right? And
ma'am, can you have a minute? I'll just take my notebook.
Suits your requirement. Please write your queries in the chat box. If you have a big question, you can write. No problem.
Okay, ma'am.
Understand your question very well. And when the session is over, please.
Thank you, ma'am.
So going ahead. See, this is a recapitulation. What we have actually done in the linear equation. We have first done the definition of the linear equation, which says that the power should be 1. If you are having a variable that is unknown variable x, then your power should be 1. You will have only one variable. You cannot have two variables because the chapter name is linear equation in one variable. So you are having only one unknown variable. Rest all the terms you should be aware of. Then coming to the second thing, you have done simplification of linear equation where you were finding the solutions of x. And third, you have done the verification of the solution. Like whatever solution you all were getting, you are verifying them that whether the left-hand side and right-hand side are equal or not. If they are equal, it is a solution. But if they are not equal, it is not a solution. Then finally, we have done some application of linear equations. In application, we have already done few. One, we have done question related to your age. Then we have done question related to your currency. And one you have done, the number puzzles. Whatever numbers you were having, you were playing with them. Basically, you were making an equation and then you were solving. Right? So what was the procedure we were following when we were doing it? Always remember these keywords because this will actually help you all in doing your sums. Whenever you are in problem, please take the help of them. You will definitely get your answers. I always get the answer from these things only. Definitely, I have to read that question many times, but then I definitely get my answers. So my very first thing is to always define your x. Whenever you are doing a question, just define your x. What is your x? What are the things which is required? Second time, please frame your equation. Why we are framing? So that we can just simplify and get the value of x. So framing is done to solve your value. Then comes your solving linear equation. Whatever you have framed, you have to solve it also. Finally, read it because sometimes they are not asking x. They are asking something else. And if you will read it properly, you can give the answer in correct statement form. All these things carry marks. You will be getting 4 out of 4 if you are concentrating on them. But yes, one more point. Because it is in statement form, if you miss the units, again, your half marks will be deducted. So always keep it in mind while revising. You should see that whether the units are there or not. If the unit, like in some question it is there, but in some it is not. So you just have to reread and recheck that yes, unit was required or not. Going ahead. This is my revision because we have done my age, currency, and this is for you to practice, right? So very first question for you all and I've given you for the practice. So let us start. If you all can give me the answer fast, I'm waiting for your answer. Mukesh is 3 times as old as Suresh. 9 years ago, the sum of their ages was 66 years. Can you tell me their present ages? Please do it in your notebook and tell me the answer. I think one person was not clear. So this is my first line from which I have to define my X. So my Suresh will be X. My Mukesh will be 3X. These are the ages. Now they are saying 9 years ago. So Suresh age will become x minus 9. Tell me the answer. I'm waiting for your answer. And Mukesh age will be 3x minus 9. Devanshi, have you got the answer? And now you have to frame an equation. The sum of their ages was 66 years. It means I have to add both of them, which should come out to be 66. Now, can anyone tell me the answer? Equation I have framed for you. I have asked the ages of both of them. Find their present ages. So it means we need the age of both, Mukesh and Suresh, both. So what will be the ages? 36 is Mukesh, okay? But Adarsh and Achal, you both are wrong till now. There is something which is missing in your answer. Years, yes. So 12 years is Suresh and 36 years is Mukesh, right? So we are just discussing the format, how to write on it. So I'm having it over here. Let Suresh age is X years, Mukesh age is 36. So your second step, 9 years ago, what were their ages? Suresh age is X minus 9, Mukesh age is 3X minus 9. Now finally, we are framing an equation. See, this what we were doing, whatever was told to us in the question. Now it is coming to our framing of equation. So when it is coming, so it is add up to 66. So I added to 66, solve and simplified. My answer is coming out to be 21. I'm getting 21. How can you get 12? 4x. 66 plus 18. I am right. So my dear, your answer is wrong, I suppose. Because x is 21, so it will be 54. Mukesh is 54. 21 into 3, 54. No, dear. See, you have done mistake here. So Suresh age is 21 years and Mukesh age is 63 years. Have you done 9 years ago also? So no, Devanshi, we don't have to do 9 years ago. No, Achal. And sorry, Adarsh, in all the cases, the present age was this only. Mukesh is 3 times as old as Suresh. This they have told 9 years ago. We want their present ages. So we'll not be doing that 21 minus 9. We'll be doing only till 21. Because we need their present age. We don't need their 9 years ago ages. So the final answer will be Suresh age is 21 years and Mukesh age will be 63 years. Don't worry. It is all practice. That is why I'm telling you, please practice. When you will practice, these type of mistakes will come your way and you have to just sort them all out. Coming to your second question. I hope this is clear to everyone. Achal, are you clear? You can write yes or no. Achal, are you clear? Fine. Good. Coming to the next. This is another one more. I've taken it from somewhere else. There were a total of 10 bicycles, but it is not total of 10. This is this, the total of 10 bicycles and tricycles in a ground. So you are having in all 10 bicycles and tricycles in a ground. If the total number of wheels were 23, how many tricycles were there? Can anyone solve? What will be my first define? How will you define? Try. How is it possible, my dear? You are having 10 bicycles, 10 only. Total is 10. How can it be 11 then? You are having total 10 bicycles and tricycles. The sum of both of them is 10. So this is not possible to be 11. That's wrong. Check your calculation. Okay, I'm coming to the solution also. let number of bicycles, I am assuming one of them to be X. I think any one I can assume. Either I can assume tricycles to be X or bicycles to be X. So after that, I have assumed this. So now wheels. In a bicycle, I am having how many wheels? I am having two wheels. So I am writing 2X and wheels in 10 minus X tricycles will be equal to 3 times, because in a tricycle, I am having 3 wheels together. 3 bracket 10 minus X. So now I am having wheels this much for your bicycles. So these are the wheels for bicycles. These are the wheels of your tricycle. If I just solve it, it will come out to be 30 minus 3x. Going ahead now. Yeah. So finally, I come to my equation. So equation becomes, because they have given total number of wheels were 23. So it will be 2x plus 30 minus 3x is equal to 23. When I further solve it, it will be minus x and it will be 23 minus 30, that is minus 7. So minus and minus cancel, you are coming out to be x is equal to 7. So what is this x stand for? This x stand for my bicycles, and 10 minus x, that is my, how many tricycles are there? 3. So in all, I am having total 3 tricycles, right? Any problem to anyone? Devanshi, this time you can reply. Any problem? Are you clear? Okay, Aryan Bhupati, are you clear? Fine. Okay, good. Very good. Aryan Bhupati, have you got your mistake in your answer? See, it's not possible to be having 11. Fine. Good. So coming to your third. Again, this is an age question. Just try to do it. It's, I have little bit modified this question over here. See, Navdeep is now 15 years older than Hardeep. Navdeep is now 15 years older than Hardeep. After 3 years, Navdeep will be 8 times as old as Hardeep was 3 years ago. So if I can read my first line, Navdeep is now 15 years older than Hardeep. So my first will be, let Hardeep is X and Navdeep will be X plus 15. Now, next line, after 3 years, Navdeep. So I'm coming to after 3 years, Navdeep age will be X plus 15 plus 3. And 3 year ago, Hardeep. So 3 year ago, Hardeep will be, what is his age? X. X minus 3. So this will become X plus 18. And this will be X minus 3. So now finally, coming to the equation, after 3 years, Navdeep will be 8 times as old as Hardeep was 3 years ago. So my equation will be X plus 18, that is Navdeep age will be 8 times Hardeep's 3 years ago age. When I finally solve, I am getting X is equal to 6. But what is the answer requirement of the answer? If you can read your question. So how old is Navdeep 2 year ago? So can you tell me Navdeep age 2 year ago? Navdeep age 2 year ago. What will be Navdeep age 2 year ago? Try. What will be his present age first? Calculate that. And from that, just subtract 2. 19 years? Yes, you are right. It is 21 years. And when I take it 2 years ago, see, now this time they have asked, ma'am, why is it written equation? So equation becomes, I did get it, because we have to frame an equation with that line. Na? That is why we are making it. We have to frame equation with this line. Just a second. See, after 3 years, ma'am, why is it written in the equation? Ma'am, it is not full. EQU. You can write EQU also, or you can write equation also. It doesn't matter. There is a shortcut for equation. You can write, no problem. If you want to write, you can write the entire equation, no problem at all, right? Any other problem to anyone? Fine, Devanshi. Fine, okay. Coming to next, it's a very simple one. I'm not doing it, this you do it actually. There are 25 paisa coins in a purse. If the total amount of money in the purse is 20.50, find the number of coins. Can you tell me? I'm counting till 30. You please give the answer immediately. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 2500. Okay, somebody else confirm? 17, 18, 19, 81. Please do. 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Nobody else got it. Try. It's a pretty easy one. See, you were having 25 paisa coins. So the money value for each coin is 25. And if you have the total money to be 20.50, I think if I convert it into the paisa form, it will be 2050. And this will be, let the coins be X. So let coin be X. So 25X is equal to 2050. X will be equal to, I think 2050 divided by 25 is 82. Am I right, Aryan? The answer is coming out to be yes, 82. You have skipped that word. That is because it was 2050. So when you divide 2050 by 25, the answer is 82. So number of 25 paisa coin will be 82. Okay. So next, one more, last. Okay, finished. Your question's finished. Right. So today what we are going to cover is a very, very important topic, number and its reverse, mensuration and fraction. The most important thing from all these is your number and its reverse, right? Because it has some format. So let us go ahead. See, when we are coming to your number and its reverse, we are dealing with specially two-digit number. Specially two-digit, there will be no three-digit number. If it is there, then they will give the value for the third number. That is why it is a two-digit number. And if we all are aware, in a two-digit number, if I am having a number as 42, so it has two places. One is your unit digit and another is your 10 digit. This unit digit is also called ones digit. And this 10th digit is same as the same. If you all have done in your earlier classes, it was like this only. It is unit digit, it is your 10 digit. It is one digit, it is your 10 digit. Right? So we are going to deal with them, especially with the two-digit numbers, right? So over here, like if you are having a number 42, how will you expand? There is some expansion way which you all have done. Yeah. Like if I give you a number 42, how will I expand? I will write this as 4 into 10. And I will write this number 2 as 2 into 1. Yes, 40 plus 2. You are absolutely right. Right? So these are two digits, 4 and 2. They are digits. And this, what we are doing is number. So understand two things. There are two different things in this particular question. Every time it will be like this only. Digits and number. That is why we are using the word number and its digits. Digits are your, what is your digit on ones place and what is your digit at tens place. Then we always take out our number. So I have done it like this also. If 10 digit is X and one digit is Y. I'm right now using two variables to make you all understand. Otherwise we will be using only one. 10 digit is X, unit or ones digit is Y. So what will be the number? Multiply your 10 digit with 10. this is digits. I want number. So when I come to the number, I want it to write in this format like you have written 40 plus 2. So it will be 10 into x plus y. And now if I reverse them, I'm reversing the digits, like I interchange the value. This will become x and this will become y. I'm interchanging them. So can anyone tell me what will be the reverse number? Digits, I have told you that it will be y and x. So what will be the reverse number? This time anyone can reply. What will be the reverse number? Reverse digit, like 42 reverse will be 24. 10y plus x, yes. So if we reverse, it will become 10y plus x. This is the format for this particular question which we have to remember. If we want to get marks, see, in this particular way, I can tell you, this carry half marks, this carry half marks, and when you form an equation, it carry one mark, because it is actually a big one. Then you solve, you are again getting marks, and finally, when you write the answer, you are again getting marks. So in this particular question, you have to remember this format. If you skip something, then your answers, maybe you will confuse your things with that. So I'm doing this. I'm again writing a format for this question, whatever the question will be. Let unit digit be something and let 10 digit be, you have to depends on the question. So your number will become 10 into 10, 1 into 1. And now I'm reversing them. So digits will change their place. Whatever your unit digit will be, it will be the actual the 10 digit. And 10 digit will be the unit digit. We get the reverse number. After that, we frame equation. And finally, we write the number. Remember, we don't want x over here. We want number. We don't want digits. We want the number. This is the main issue of this question, that we want number. So coming to one of the example here. See, if you can read. In our two-digit number, the digit at tens place is 4 times that of unit digit. So if I can see from here, my unit digit will become x and my digit at tens place will be 4x. Now, can anybody tell me the number? What will be the number? This is my 10 unit digit. This is my 10 digit. So what will be the number? Anyone can write in the chat box. What will be the number? 45, but I have not given you the value of x. So how can you get the value of x and then you get it 45? No. Multiply this 4x with 10 to get the value. And multiply this x, which is your unit digit, with 1. So what will be the number? 40x, yes, Archer. 40x plus x. The answer will come out to be 41x. Yeah, this is perfect first step, right? So I have done this first step. Now coming to your second step, reverse them, right? Reverse your digits and then get your new number. So now from my side, unit digit will be 4x and this will be x. So it will be 10x plus 4x. So what is the reverse number? Reverse number now. This is your unit digit, this is your 10 digit. So what is your reverse number? 14x, correct. Now let us read the question to frame our equation. If 54 is subtracted from the number, the digits are reversed. If 54 is subtracted from the number, so now what will be my equation? Can anybody frame an equation here? If 54 is subtracted from the number, the digits are reversed. Find the number. 14x minus 54. 14x, why 14x? They are saying 54 is subtracted from the number. So it will be, yes, 41x minus 54 is equal to 14x. See, 54 subtract from number, then the digits are reversed. The reverse number is 14x. Finally, we solve them. So I hope this time it's very clear. So how to write, this was a way actually. So coming to the second part, reverse the digits. So So when we reverse, unit digit is 4x, 10 digit is x. So reverse number will be 10x plus 4x, 14x. Now I'm making my equation. So equation becomes 41x minus 54, which is equal to 14x. So the value of x is 2. But remember, they don't want x. They want number. So the number is, because unit digit is 2 and 10 digit is 8. So the number will come out to be 82. Anyone having any problem in this?
No, ma'am.
Fine. I'm giving a little bit practice of this particular question only because it requires a lot of things to be kept in mind. And if you can see very clearly, these are type, how you will get the marks? You will get the marks like this. For one step, for second step, for third one, for fourth one, and for the last. The marks are distributed like this. So if anything miss, you will not get the marks over there. Yeah, by chance the answer is right and you are skipping one or two lines, then they definitely give it, but it's better to write all of them so that each and every confusion is finished. So coming to the second question, you try the second question now.
Yes, ma'am.
Try this one. In a two-digit number, the digit at ones place is twice that of tenth digit. Another number formed by reversing the digits is more than the original number by 27. So what should be the original number? So can anyone write what will be the my one digit and 10 digit? One digit and 10 digit. One digit first and 10 digit second. So I think 10 digit will be X. One digit will be 2X. Yes, correct. So what will be the number?
Poor connection.
Yes. So what will be the number?
So I may leave.
The number is 12x, I suppose. Now you find the reverse number. I think it should be 21x, but just try. Maybe I think I'm wrong. What will be the reverse number? Anybody got 21x? Sure. Okay, let me see. Yes, you are right, Arun. This time it is 21x. But it doesn't look nice to write x21, so it's better way to write is 21x, right? Otherwise, it's fine. So now, what will be the equation? Can anyone write the equation also? Then only you will get clear pictures. Who can write the equation correct? Another number formed by reversing the digits is greater than the original number. Yes, perfect answer. You are right, but I have made it another way, so equation becomes, because they are saying that it is more, so I can write like this also. 21x minus 12x is equal to 27. Finally we solve and we get the answer for x, and then I put this value of x in this. 10 digit is 3 and one digit is 6. So the number will be 36. I think now many of you have got the idea how to do all of them, right? Try this one. Sure, okay, fine. See, this time I have changed not twice, not four times, but this time I have changed the number. Sum of the digits of a two-digit number is 14. So if one number is 2, no, it's not possible to be 2. If one number is 6, another number will be 8. So this time, because it is given sum of both of them, so I have to assume 10 digit be x, one digit be 14 minus. You can assume vice versa also, it doesn't matter. But then go according to your requirement, what you are writing. Because if I'm writing this, I will solve according to this. If you are taking another way, 14 minus x and x, you will solve that way. So it is on you how you have to solve. But since I have assumed this, you can continue ahead like this. So number will be, you have to multiply this 10 digit with 10. So it will be 10x. And this number will be 14 minus x. So when I simplify, it is 9x plus 14. Now you tell me the reverse number. Achal, please write the reverse number. I need the reverse number from you. Now it won't be 14 plus 9x, no. 14x plus 9. Okay, Aaron, let me see. This time also, see, if I reverse, the 10 digit will become 14 minus 6. Won't I multiply it with 10? Right? So when I multiply it with 10, I'm getting 140 minus 10x. And my one digit will be x only, because 1 into x. So when I simplify it further, it will be 140 minus 9x. Am I right, Aryan? Any problem, Aryan? Okay, fine. That's okay. Not a problem. So I hope now you are clear why I'm writing 140 minus 10x and plus x. It will be 140 minus 9x. So let us go ahead. Now I frame my equation. So for framing, they wrote the number obtained by interchanging the digits exceeds the given number. Means reverse number minus given number is equal to 36. So it is my reverse number, my original number. Since it was minus, so I have to change the sign of both of them, is equal to 36. And while I solve, I'm getting my x as 5. So 10 digit is 5 and 1 digit is 9. So therefore, my original number will come out to be 59. So any problem to anyone in this question here? You will be having these type of questions for the digits. That is why if you all can observe, for the first, these steps are same for everyone. They will not change from 10 digit to reverse number. Finally, we have to come to equation. So first we have to write by looking onto the first line. Till the time we will not define properly and we are not having the numbers, we can't frame our equation. So first define, get your numbers, and then frame your equation. Because without the numbers, your equation will not come out to be right. You have to frame your equation using your numbers, not the digits. Digits are helping to make a number. By number, we are able to make the reverse number, and then we come to the framing of equations. So I think this is clear. One more. Okay. This is your number and its digit, right? You are having only these three, four types of questions wherever if you can search in your books. I have searched many books. Yeah, definitely it can be difference of the two digit number also. So when you are having difference, it can be x and x plus 3. It depends on the question, what is given in the question. That's why I'm telling you, practice it and tell me any problem coming your way so that we can all practice that particular question. So I'm coming to the next topic. This is called mensuration. And in mensuration, we are generally covering your area, your perimeter, and basically your angles, which you have all done in your class, class 7th, and in class 7th, you have done special chapter of area perimeter also. So basically your mensuration questions are based on these three particular topics, right? So I've just covered a little bit more of them. So before going ahead, I'm having the formulas for all of them so that by chance, if you skip a formula, then you can understand. So these are the formulas related to your area. Area of square will be side into side. Your rectangle is length into breadth. Your triangle, you have done half into base into altitude. And I think you have done in class 7 parallelogram also, which says base into altitude. Then there are few formulas for your perimeter. Actually, perimeter is sum of all sides. So your square will be 4 into side. Your rectangle will be twice length plus breadth. Your triangle is sum of all sides. And last, your parallelogram, because in this we cannot take length and breadth, because that standing one is not breadth, it is altitude actually. So in the parallelogram, we consider them base 1 plus base 2 and multiply it by 2 so that we can get the double of that. And what is sum of the angles of a triangle is 180. Generally, you are using these only. Yes, altitude means height. You are right. So coming to the one question which I have done. See, it's a very simple one which they have given. Perimeter of a rectangle is 13 centimeter. Width of the rectangle is 11 by 4 centimeter. Find its length. Because they have given a very crystal clear question. So your length will be x. Perimeter is according to the formula. It will be 2l plus b. Just substitute your value x plus 11 by 4. In these type of questions, you will have these fractions which are coming your way. So if you want to remove your fraction, you can take the LCM. But if you don't want to remove them, first you multiply them and get your unknown terms here or known terms on this side, then solve. This is also one way of doing it. So it is calculation is totally your wish now in how many steps you are doing it. So finally the answer, is my answer right? What am I missing now? Have I missed something? What will be my last line? Centimeter. So the statement line length is equal to 3.75 centimeter. Yes, right? I don't want x, I want length. In the question, they have not given me find x. They have told me find length. So my final statement answer should be my length is equal to 3.75 centimeter. Coming to next. Yeah, this you try. It's a bit calculative and it has one more concept into it, right? An altitude of a triangle. Yeah, an altitude of a triangle is 2/3 of the length of its base. So what will be my base? If I can understand, it will be 2/3 of its base. The base is x and this will be 2/3 of x. Now they are increasing the altitude by 2 and base by 2. Sorry, base is decreased by 2. So it means altitude, whatever altitude you are having, in this you are having as altitude as 2/3x. And now increase it by 2. Yeah. And base is decreased by 2. So it will be x minus 2. Right? They are saying in both the cases, the area will remain same. Area will not change. And they are asking me find the base and altitude of the triangle. Right? So coming to the question. Yeah, base is x, altitude is 2/3 x. So area will be 1/2 into x into 2/3 of x. See over here, if you can see, it is coming in x square. This is one more concept in this particular question. You can get like this also. X into x is x square. 2 and 2 cancel. So you are getting 1/3 x square. Now I am changing the things. New base. Yeah. New base is x minus 2. And new altitude is 2/3 x plus 2. Again, I have to calculate the area. For area, 1/2 into new base into new altitude. So when I multiply, first I'm multiplying with x. So it will be x into 2x/3, it is 2x² / 3. X into 2x. Where is it this gone? 4x/3. Okay, I have done this first. Okay. So x into 2 will be 2x here. Then I'm multiplying it with this. So it will be -4x/3 and -4. Now I am opening the bigger one. I am taking this 1/2 also into consideration. So it will be 2x² / 6, 4x/3 into 2. So it will be 2x/3 plus x minus 4. I think this I have skipped. So 4 will become 2. It won't be 4 because 2 and 1/2 into minus 4 will be this. So now let us solve the question ahead. Just a second, yeah. So coming back to the question over here, since it is like this, it will be 2 here. Right? Any problem till this to anyone? I'll go back to because this is a very major question here. Any problem, Achal? Any problem to you? I think it's clear. Aaron Bhupati, is it clear? Clear, fine. Okay. Yeah. See, it is minus 2, fine now. Okay, coming ahead. See, what then we have done, because this is 2 here. See, if you can see over here, because this time you are having x square. So first, this has to go. So I am cutting this and this. So it will be 3. So if you all can see, this and the entire thing is cancelling it out. So you are having x upon 3 minus 2 is equal to 0. You are not having anything. So when you simplify them, you get x is equal to 6. So finally, your equation is this. X by 3 minus 2 is equal to 0. I understand, because there was there it was x square. So it was not a linear equation. But then you can cancel it, because it was there on both sides. And finally, we make a linear equation. So this is one more thing in this particular question. You will be getting like this type of question where you are asked like this. That first simplify, then cut your x square, and then x by 3 minus 2 will be equal to 0. So your x will come out to be 6. And using that thing, my base will be 6 centimeter. And now 2 by 3 of 6 will be 4 centimeter. So this is not 8, this is 4 centimeter. I'm clear? Aryan, are you clear? You want to ask anything? You can ask. Devanshi, are you clear? This requires your practice. You all have to practice, because without practice, you all can't get them. It requires, because first you have to frame. Fine. Okay. Right. Next, this is one more question. It is based on this only, but this time it is not your perimeter area. Because these type of questions are there. Now, this is your fraction. Now, when you are doing your fraction, you are always having a form numerator upon denominator. Again, in this also, they are not asking you numerator, denominator. They are asking you fraction. Right? But we should be very clear that what is the concept behind that. We will be using it, and then we will be going it ahead. X minus 7 upon x. Yes, perfect. The numerator of a fraction is 7 less than the denominator. So I'm assuming my denominator to be x. My numerator will become x minus 7. Now, denominator is increased by 9. So denominator will become x plus 9. And okay, it is both times the same thing. I think my mistake. I'll just tell you in this one. Yeah, so it is numerator. Yeah, it is numerator, which is increased by 2. So x minus 7 plus 2. So this is not denominator, it is numerator. It is x plus 9 and x minus 5. This is the one new fraction. See, now you are having a fraction, you are having a new fraction. Now I have to go back and read the question to see what is the equation they want. So the numerator of a fraction is 7 less than the denominator. If the denominator is increased by 9 and numerator is increased by 2, the fraction remains unchanged. It means fraction and new fraction, both are same. They are not changed. So my equation will come out to be x minus 7 upon x is equal to x minus 5 upon x plus 9. See, now again, when I'm going to solve, I have to multiply these two, x minus 7 and x plus 9. I have to multiply. So when I'm first multiplying with this x, so it will be x square and then minus 7x. So I got the answer. X minus 7 is multiplied by x first. So it is x square minus 7x. And now I'm multiplying it with 9. So x into 9 is 9x and 7 into 9 is 63. But the sign minus into plus is minus. So minus 63. Similarly, multiply this side also. It's a cross multiply actually. That is why we have earlier done your simplification first, where we have told you how to cross multiply them. So it will be x square minus 5x. Now you can very easily cut your x square. This is again your linear equation. So it will be minus 7x plus 9x, which is 2x. And now minus 5x transpose, that is 7x, which is equal to 63. So your x is 63, but this is your x. So what is your denominator and numerator? Can anyone write? What is my denominator? Denominators I've got 9. What is my numerator? Anyone can write? 2 by 9? 2, 9. Okay, let me see. So numerator is 2, denominator is 9. So your fraction will be 2 by 9. Everything clear? See, these are the type of questions which they will be asking you all. So you have to understand the key behind them. Like you have done digits, you have done your area, you have done your perimeter, you have done your fraction. In all the cases, see, starting is while reading the question only, you have to analyze. In mensuration, we are creating formulas. In digits, we are having expanded form. And in this fraction, we are having numerator and denominator. In all the questions, what we are having the link, let read first, come to your define. When the definition is done, come to your framing, then finally solve, get your answer, and then finally read what they want. Then only you will get your full out of full. Okay, coming to the next. See, what you have done, basically now I'm doing the analysis of the entire chapter. When you are revising your linear equation in one variable, you should always know that you should be aware of how to simplify, then how to verify the solution. And for verification, use left hand side and right hand side separately, not together. If you do it together, that will be a wrong case. You can put a line or you can do separately. We need a separate answer for left hand side and separate answer for your right hand side. And then when we come to the application, age, mensuration, number reverse, money and its denomination, number puzzles and fractions. Some extras are also there, but they are also counted in numbers only. So it's not a big problem. So you can all practice. Now this time I have given the entire crux of the chapter, and the main crux to understand your word problems are define, frame, solve and write. Then you will be able to analyze your question and solve. But you all have just given some practice sums. Question number one, be ready to write. A rectangle whose length is twice of breadth has perimeter dash. So what is the perimeter? Write fast. What is the perimeter? 2L plus 2B. No, my dear. See, a rectangle whose length is twice of breadth. This time assume your breadth, okay, it is B. So your length will be 2B. So what is your perimeter? Solve, solve, solve. Get an answer. Anshul, you are right. I need one expression. The answer is 6 times. That is 6 into B. 6B. Or you can write 6X. But they have not specified anything over here. So we have to write 6 times its breadth. Otherwise, if they have told, assume your breadth to be X, then you can. Right? Because it's a fill-up. Then a fill-up, what is given to you, you have to analyze accordingly. So read your questions properly. You'll understand them. Question number two. The value of the variable that satisfies the equation is called... Hurry up. Anyone can tell? Solution. No, it's not equal to, it's not plus. Yes, it's solution. Because it's an equation and we are getting the value which satisfies it. So it's a solution. Coming to the third question. If 8x, 5x plus 20 and 2x plus 10 are the angles of the triangle, find the value of x. So what will be my value of x? Try. Hope you all are aware, they are the angles of the triangle. So what will be the value of x? 10. Somebody else? Then only I'll confirm. Okay, two of you have confirmed, so let us see. Yes, the value of x is 10. Hope you are clear, because 8x, because we are writing angles of a triangle and we are aware that sum of the angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. And if the sum of the angles of triangle is 180 degrees, so I have to add all of them. It will be 8x plus 5x plus 20 plus 2x plus 10 is equal to 180. When I simplify them, I think 8x, 5x and 2x It's coming out to be 15x, and 20 plus 10 is 30. So 180 minus 30 will come out to be 150. And over here it is 15x. Right? So when I cancel them up, it's coming out to be 10. Right? Coming to the next one. If one of the complementary angles is twice the other, then the two angles are, this you can write very fast. Somebody else to confirm? I don't know the answer. You are telling. So one more one. I want one more answer. 60-30. Okay, RM Bhupati, you have corrected it. See, you can always recheck your answers, right? This is what I was trying to tell you. In 45-45, one is not twice the other. But in 60 and 30, if you can see, they are complementary also, and one angle is twice the other. So in your word problems, whatever question like it, I can show you. In all the questions, you can recheck your answers. Everywhere you can recheck. Like if you have done digits. See, when I was getting the answer over here, I can cross-check my answers. Like 59 is the answer. And if I reverse, it is 95. So 95 minus 59 is 36. I can very easily check my answers in this and can get my mistake very clearly. Right? What are they asking? Always, if in doubt, always recheck your answer by cross-checking them. When you cross-check your answer, you will come to know your mistakes only. Definitely, by these ways, you will get your answers and you will come to know your mistakes also. I think that's all. Any problem to anyone? Any slide, any number, anything which is not clear to you? This is your doubt time. So you can ask. Anything? Nobody want to ask anything? No doubts? So okay, now tell me how many of you have practiced. Then I'll give you a few questions. I'll give you a question now. If you all are having no doubt, then let me give you a question. Okay. Ready to practice? Otherwise, it's over. But I'll give you a question. Wait. I'm having a very difficult book with me in my hand, which is a bit complicated for everyone. So I'll give you that complicated one. Okay. So here is your question. The denominator of a, because it's a denominator question, so I'll write here only. The denominator of a rational number is less than its numerator by 2. Again, I'm repeating, you have to tell me your denominator and numerator. The denominator of a rational number is less than its numerator by 2. So what will be my numerator? My numerator will be x and denominator is less than 2. So your denominator will be x minus 2. Very right. Okay. Coming ahead. If the numerator is decreased by 5, so I'm decreasing it by 5. If the numerator is decreased by 5 and the denominator is increased by 1, so x minus 2 plus 1. The new number becomes 1 by 3. Sorry, the new number becomes 2 by 3. What is this new number? What will I write here? What is my new number? They have written 2 by 3. But now what should be my new number according to the variables x? Try. X minus 5 upon x minus 1. Now you simplify it, it will be 3x. Can anyone simplify fast? X minus, yes, correct. So 3x minus 15 is equal to 2x minus 2. So your x will be coming out to be equal to minus 2 plus 15, 13. Now can anyone tell me number? What is the fraction? What will be my fraction? X is 13. So what will be my fraction? 13 by 11. Anand, how can it be 8 by 7? It will be 13, na? X is 13. Okay, might be you have gone to 13 minus 5. No, they don't want this. This is for framing the equations. This is your fraction. So it will be 13 upon 11. Right? It won't be 8 by 7. We will not use them. We will use this because this was our actual thing. This is new thing which we have done by decreasing and increasing. That's why. Any other problem anyone having? Otherwise, we are done. Next time, we'll do another topic. So if you have any problem, you can write in the chat box. Any problem to anyone? All okay? Hello, if all okay, then we all leave. Okay? Bye.
Bye, ma'am. Okay.